I'm Amy Okamura-Jones from My Neighbour Totoro.
Hi, my name is May Mack from My Neighbour Totoro.
It's amazing to have you here tonight. Can you talk a little bit about what is so magical about this story and specifically the live theatre experience of it?
It has been an honour to adapt something that is loved by so many people across the world, and for us the opportunity to be so creative with it. I mean, when you watch the film, you sort of go, how on earth are they going to stage that? Mm-hmm. And so with this crack team of artists working at the top of their game, it feels like we've pulled something really special off. Mm-hmm. So when anyone comes to see the show, I think they sort of go, wow, they've done it, and it feels really special, but it doesn't feel big. It doesn't feel like it's beyond anyone else's capabilities. It's intimate, and it's full of heart. So we're really, really proud of it.
Yeah. And what's amazing about My Neighbour Totoro is how much of a milestone and landmark it is for the East and Southeast Asian community, and what an incredible thing it is to have all this incredible and talent on stage and off stage. And we are so proud to be representatives of it.
In terms of, I mean, the astonishing output of Studio Ghibli, can you talk a little bit about, like you say, in terms of that global understanding of Asian art, Asian storytelling, what that's meant, really?
We are so proud to be working, not just with our community, but for our community. And that's part of the joy of sharing this, that it's our gift to our audiences to share the culture of Ghibli, share East Asian culture, to share Japanese culture, but to do it in a way that feels really authentic and really empowering for all of us. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous gift.
And also just incredible to go, you know, we broke the Barbican box office record on the first day ticket sales opened, and to go, we are here, our stories are worth telling, and people want to come see those shows sell. So there's not an excuse anymore for excluding us creatively and artistically.
The thing about My Neighbour Totoro is that, yes, it's about the magic of it and the wonder and nature, but it's ultimately so incredibly human. That it's about grief and the power of hope and the celebration of like really simply existing. I think that's why it touches people, because it's not trying to follow a really intense plot line or storyline. It's just celebrating existing. And with everything that we as a society have gone through in the past few years, that's something that we really need, to stop for a minute, celebrate the fact that we're alive and reconnect with each other and nature. It's reminded me of all those things as well.
I'm curious, I mean, you mentioned obviously the unique production challenges of adapting the iconic film. Is there a particular sequence, a particular scene in the production that you think is the most impressive in terms of how that's been achieved?
Oh my God, what a fantastic question. There are so many sequences in the show that are absolutely mind-blowing. It's hard to name one, but hearing the audience's reaction every night when Totoro himself is finally revealed, I mean, that is just spectacular. And to hear from their reaction, to know we've nailed it, and they see him really alive on stage, that's a magical moment.
Of all the amazing places in the world to perform for audiences, can you talk about the unique appeal of London for so many people?
I mean, London, obviously I'm biased as a Londoner, but I'm so grateful to live in a city that has so much art infused. And I think the hope that this story will bring people who never go to the theatre, who can't, to come to the theatre. Studio Ghibli has such a wide appeal, so we're hoping that it has brought new audiences to the theatre and that they'll fall in love with theatre full stop, not just our show. And so I'm grateful that we've opened it in London, and I'm hoping that we can share it with other people in other cities and other countries, and who knows, we have so many hopes for it, but nothing confirmed so far.
I mean, I adore London. You know, the diversity, the creativity, the messiness, the expensiveness, the vibrancy of it. So I love performing in the city, and it's my home.
Do you have a message for all of the devoted Ghibli fans watching this all around the world? Because I think, you know, more so than almost any other creative endeavor, people love this studio, its work in all its formats, and it really means a lot to them when they get to experience something new like this show.
Thank you for supporting us. Thank you for loving it as much as we have loved making it. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to create something so magical and coming on this journey with us. And, you know, like the fans at home, we are also huge fans. And so it really feels like a community collective endeavour. So massive thank yous.
Much the same. Thank you. And it's been the honour of a lifetime to play this part.